closing in on walkouts and kickoff from Chicago, the U.S. and Guatemala just minutes away. Again, a frustrating, but in the end, a win, a three-point win, a shutout for the U.S. two nights ago. Eric, how do you expect them to start tonight versus Guatemala?
Hit first, hit hard, and don't stop. I mean, that you get to that halftime whistle with a lead. That's the number one thing that has to be in their mind, and they just got to get ahead of this game. Can't be chasing it.
Two nights ago, they went to the halftime locker room tied at zeros.
No good.
Folks, players kind of bickering amongst each other. Joe Ellis making several changes to the lineup right now. It'll be interesting to see how that plays out. See how it plays out.
Let's go.
Early. Let's go.
Game time.
Let's go. Let's go to Chicago. JP Della Camera. Cat Whitehill with the first half call. Hi, guys.
Thank you, Rob. Hi, how are you tonight? Kat, what are you expecting tonight from this game?
Well, I absolutely agree with Eric. When the United States is going to go hard, they're going to go fast. They want to prove something from the last game. They want to score on every opportunity, and they want to use the width a lot more and not just go centrally.
Well, the team made several lineup changes coming in a game, too. Who do we look for to make an impact in that lineup?
We actually look for Megan Rapinoe. Even though she started in the last game, she started on the wide left side. This time, she's in that number 10 playmaker role that Abby Wambach was in the last game, but Abby Wambach plays a higher role because she's a forward that wants to keep getting forward, and Megan Rapinoe is going to really key on connecting with Carly Lloyd and Lauren Holiday that are in that deeper midfielder role. So see the difference between Megan Rapinoe and Abby Wambach in that playmaker role.
Teams are in the tunnel, ready to come out onto this field at Toyota Park in Bridgeview, Illinois, home of the Chicago Fire. It's an important game, too, for the United States off of a 1-0 narrow victory over Trinidad and Tobago. They're certainly looking for more this evening against the Guatemala side that lost 1-0 to Haiti. Two teams side by side as we await the anthems of the two countries.
Thank you.
Welcome back, everyone, to the 2014 CONCACAF Women's Championship here on Fox Sports as the USA gets ready to take on Guatemala. We mentioned changes in the lineup. Here is the USA's starting 11.
Well, they start out on a 4-3-3, but there's a lot of interchanging going on, so keep an eye out for the wide players. Sydney LaRue and Allie Krieger on the right, and Tobin Heath and Megan Klingenberg on the left. Look for their relationship and both the outside backs getting forward and getting into the attack as much as possible.
On the opposite side for Guatemala, they also have made some changes from their first game. What do they look like tonight, Kat?
Well, it's interesting. They're going to be looking in a much more defensive role, and the key for them is going to be number 8, Maria Monterosa, up top. She is going to have to hold the ball, give their team some time to get up with her, and get their defense a little bit of rest.
USA will be in white. Guatemala in blue. Let's go downstairs to the third member of our team, Jenny Taft.
Well, you guys mentioned those lineup changes, but there are still 8 members of this team that will be making their second start in 3 days. I talked to fitness coach Don Scott, who told me that the recovery process started immediately after Wednesday night's match. It continued yesterday, even though it was an off day. The team participated in some light training to get their legs moving and make sure they're rested and ready before tonight's match.
Jenny, thank you. Kat, you know all about this because you had to do this before when you played for the U.S. national team for the better part of a decade. What is it like with so little rest in between?
Well, it's tough. I mean, these games, they wear on you. You're running a lot. You want to win. There's a lot of pressure on you. The nerves are going. And it's interesting, you know, hearing about the Dawn Scott and what she's doing for recovery. Everything is player specific. It's not broad. It's how much protein, if they like milk, you know, how much ice bathing. If they're going to go into heat, ice. It's so interesting and it's so scientific. I wish I had that back in the day.
I'm just going to ask you if they had made changes since then. Obviously, they have. When you talk about the little bit of rest and recovery that these two teams have, the concern would be more for Guatemala's players who do not have the same kind of treatment, we'll say, that the U.S. players have. Benjamin Monterosso, the head coach of Guatemala. 2 of his daughters play for his side, both in the starting lineup. One is the team captain, number 14, Coralia Monterosso. We await the whistle from Maurice Skeet from Guyana, who is our match referee. And we are underway. Guatemala on the ball, trying to send it long immediately. And the U.S. will collect it deep in their own half. Push to the right side, Whitney Engen. Up the wing for Allie Krieger, the right back. Second straight start for Krieger. Worked it in the middle. Lauren Holiday. She'll quarterback the side, but from a deeper role, Kat.
Yeah, deeper than she's used to. When she played for FC Kansas City, she was more in that playmaker role. And Jill Ellis, when we talked to her this morning, she really wanted to emphasize the fact that her role is still evolving. While she's in a deeper role for now, she really wants Lauren Holiday to give forward because she has such incredible vision and she can really play the forwards and outside backs into the attack, and she's so dangerous at doing it.
Well, last touch by Allie Krieger. Guatemala will put it back into play with the throw-in. Jill Ellis all bundled up, yet to lose as the head coach of this team. 11 wins and 3 draws in 14 games. Sauerbrunn over to Engen. Flips forward, and that's going to be cleared away by Rivera. And the U.S. will collect it back in the halfway line. We'll see how they combine tonight. They had a difficult time, even though they had a lot of shots against Trinidad and Tobago. It's not always easy to break a bunker.
It's not. Guatemala is looking very similar to Trinidad and Tobago with the 5 back. Looks like a 5-4-1 and dropping very low because they know how fast and dynamic the United States attack is.
LaRue to the right for Krieger. The give and go. Number 2 was LaRue. Tackled out of play again by Rivera. He played a full 90 the other night against Haiti. Holiday looking up. Didn't see any other option. No one open. Now she'll spray it wide. Almost made it across on that left side. But instead it's picked off. On the chase, Sauerbrunn. It's going to be knocked out of play. Guatemala will have a throw-in.
And that's something that we talked to with Jill Ellis about a lot, is those flank spaces that are open because the outside backs are going forward so much. She said in the formation that she wants, there's a lot of risk about going forward as an outside back, so there's a lot of space, and that's just something they have to learn to deal with.
Off that throw on the far side of the field. Guatemala will try to push it inside. That one's cut off. Pushed to the side by Sauerbrunn. And the U.S. will start from that left flank. Guatemala made a few changes from the other night. Perhaps resting some players. Holiday's long ball intended for Morgan. You can see how many were back there. Five almost in a line for Guatemala. Right side for LaRue. The cross. Header by Lloyd is wide. Crossing, though, is one of the areas that they wanted to work on. They were not happy at all with the service from the flanks the other night.
Jill, let's talk all about how they didn't use the width enough. They tried to force everything central. Sydney LaRue and Tobin Heath are in that outside space in this game, and they've already utilized Sydney LaRue out there. Sydney LaRue likes to go inside because she is a natural forward, but she is so dangerous on that outside winger area. You can see that cross was excellently sent in and just missed from Carly Lloyd.
Kept on the ground towards Rapino, and it's going to be knocked out of play by Aguilar. Throw-in for the United States deep in Guatemala territory. Klingenberg's going to take it instead for Rapino. Partially blocked. U.S. still advances in the box of Guatemala. Play back. Quick one in front, and it's too far wide. And Carly Lloyd, who made that run to the far post.
Klingenberg tries to find Carly Lloyd. It could have also gone in for a shot, but just misses the outside and far post.
Scoreless here in the fifth minute. United States versus Guatemala. Game two for each of these clubs in Group A. Espino gave it away. Heath. Holiday. Terrific idea as Krieger tries to catch up to that ball, but that's the vision of Holiday. Not as precise a pass as she's made maybe in the past, but the ability to certainly make that connection.
Absolutely. She has the vision, and her range is second to none. She can spray the ball on a dime. She just missed Allie Krieger running down that right side, but she saw her early. And Allie Krieger, if you can get her into the attacking third and on that end line, she is so dangerous with her crosses.
Push forward by De Leon, broken up by the U.S. Sauerbrunn tried to get it, cleared the other way bit. Espino. Klingenberg back after it for the U.S. Engen up the middle. Holiday goes forward. Got it free to the outside. Now the USA have numbers forward. Five, make it six in the attack. Rapino in the middle, cutting it back nicely. Rapino towards the flank. Morgan cutting, end line, played it back across. Blocked up the middle, a bad spot for the clearance. Rapino's back on it. Holiday looks, finds Krieger. Looks to cross it in front. It's a loose ball and tapped home. The USA has scored. Tobin Heath is on the board.
This is Allie Krieger. She's so dangerous when she gets to that end line. It's a good cross in and just tapped, and Tobin Heath is able to finish it. And this is what the United States couldn't do in the last game. Getting a lot of players in the box and finishing when it's bouncing around. Guatemala was unable to clear it, and it looks like Tobin Heath stayed onside and was able just to put it underneath Navas's hands.
Well, you talked before the game about the U.S. wanting to and needing to score early, even though they didn't look all that sharp. In the first 4 or 5 minutes, they get that first goal.
Yeah, and it's a relief for them. They were so frustrated after the Trinidad-Tobago game with missed opportunities and unforced errors that we just saw right there. But this time, you could tell that they were focused in the box because that was the missed opportunity so often in the last game. They weren't about to let that happen at that point.
Ball back to Whitney Engen. Into the middle for Sauerbrunn. Klingenberg holds. Back for Sauerbrunn. Plays for FC Kansas City. Champions of the NWSL this past season. LaRue to Krieger. The right back way upfield. Guatemala trying to take over. Here's where Guatemala has to be very careful. The U.S. could really open things up after scoring that first goal. Holiday pushing forward, sending it across the way. Guatemala's able to deal with that. They couldn't clear it away. Rapino in the air helps out for Heath. Klingenberg chased back. Sauerbrunn to Engen. Pushing forward, going to the right side, a bit too far for Krieger. One of those unforced errors that plagued the U.S. the other night.
Well, this is a replay of the goal. Coming from a good angle, you can see Sidney LaRue almost was able to score, but Tobin Heath was able to finish it, and Jill Ellis looks very happy and probably a little more relieved that this goal came a little bit earlier in this game.
Talked about the unforced errors the other night, Kat. Something like 41 from the other night. U.S. not happy with that. They're looking for a number less than 15. Here's the U.S. attacking now. Heath towards the end line, cuts the ball across. Guatemala with another bad clearance. Holiday's pass, then Lloyd. Intended for Rapino, cut off by Espino. Upfield towards Monterroso, who, unlike the other night against Haiti, hasn't even touched the ball so far.
Talk about the unforced errors, and when we talked to Jill Ellis about it, she's like, they know that we're keeping count of how many unforced errors, and an acceptable is less than 15, and they had 41 or so, they believe, and you could tell that she was very frustrated with that number, and that was the reason why they weren't having good chemistry during that Trinidad Tobago game, and they were just a little step off, especially in that attacking third.
Carly Lloyd, she can shoot from distance, chooses not to there, sent it in low, and it was blocked out for a corner kick. Lloyd tonight wearing the captain's armband, Christy Rampone, available on the subs bench. Megan Rapinoe's going to come over to take this next corner. Without targets like Abby Wambach, who do you look for here?
Well, you look for Carly Lloyd, and you look for Sidney LaRue. They're excellent in the air, and honestly, unfortunately for Guatemala, they are a smaller team. So you can see in that picture right there that most United States players are taller than the Guatemalan players.
Rapino sends it in low. It bounces away. Partially hit there by Lloyd. Headed forward by Heath, and it's going to go out of play. Throw in for Guatemala. U.S. leads here in the 11th minute. And a goal by Tobin Heath in the 7th minute of play. Took him into the second half to get that first goal of the other night against Trinidad and Tobago when Wambach scored in the 54th minute. Sauerbrunn to the right. Engen. Holiday has seen an awful lot of the ball, quarterbacking this team from a deep spot. Seems to have pushed forward more at the start of this game than the other night against Trinidad and Tobago. This ball out of play. Another one of those unforced errors.
And you can actually see the coaches of the United States getting up off their bench because they're upset about that unforced error. That's just too simple. And they really want to work on the buildup in this tournament, and they just haven't executed it well enough for them to feel comfortable with the buildup going forward.
Espino trying to flick it long. Monterroso. From Solorzano. Guatemala, unlike the other night, so little possession here. Over the top. That's a ball they think they can capitalize on to Morgan, but it's cleared away. Goalkeeper came out. Navas, she did not start the other night. Franco was in goal for Guatemala. But that's a ball that the U.S. thinks that they can be able to play very successfully against Guatemala.
Well, there's a five back for Guatemala, but they do get a little high when they're pushing out of the United States. If Alex Morgan, who's staying the highest board, can stay high enough, she can really get in with her speed. And this is a foul on Carly Lloyd. Looks like she kind of went in a little reckless. But that's where the United States can really capitalize if the United States is very patient and smart on their runs.
On yesterday's off day, Carly Lloyd got traded to the Houston Dash for her USA teammate Whitney Engen and Becky Edwards. So it was a busy day, busier day for some members of the U.S. team.
Well, and it's interesting timing in the middle of a big tournament for Carly Lloyd and Whitney Engen to deal with the fact that they're going to a new city. They already have enough pressure right now with World Cup qualifying, and now they have to, you know, accept the change. They're okay with the change, but it's just, you know, something to think, something more to think about.
Heath, Morgan makes a run into the middle of the box. Towards Morgan, it bounces away. Sydney LaRue is back on it. Communicates with Krieger to make that run, but it's knocked out of play. Throw in for the U.S. Krieger will take it. Holiday. Settled by Klingenberg. Back for Holiday. Tap back. Holiday, short pass. Rapinoe chipping it in. The look was intended for Lloyd. LaRue back on it. Tap it out. Another corner for the U.S.
Sydney LaRue is one of those players that could be in the starting lineup. There's a lot of players that are vying for those front four positions, and Sydney LaRue really believes that she should be in there. And one of the factors that's going to determine whether she is a starter is her relationship with that outside back. So look for her and Allie Krieger and how well they can connect in this game.
Rapinoe's corner. There's a push in the box. No foul called. Shot taken from distance is blocked. At the end line, the offside flag goes up. Morgan was definitely pushed inside. Looking live, that's a penalty kick. We'll see if it looks the same on replay. Yeah,
it looked like she absolutely got pushed, and she did. She was going for the ball. She had the clear advantage, and then look at there, just completely pushed. The referee absolutely missed it.
Someone who knows all about this, Dr. Joe Macnick, your thoughts on that?
Well, it looks to be a clear penalty kick, pushing in the penalty area. It's without question. The player had a chance for the ball and was never given that chance because of the foul.
I wonder, Dr. Joe, her positioning, was she in a good spot to make that call? Just chose to ignore it?
Well, you know, then you get help from the assistant referee. So between the two of them, one of them has to see this, and they communicate with each other with the communication device and get the call right.
Right. Thank you, Doctor. Looks like one was missed there. Cat, a 1-0 lead for the U.S. and a goal by Tobin Heath. Ball played long again. It's intended for Morgan. Espino in the middle. Blocked, and the foul goes against the United States.
Honestly, it looked like pass interference on Alex Morgan. She had the clear advantage. And I just have to say, I'm pretty proud that I actually got a call right, because normally I'm yelling at referees and they always think I'm wrong. So I'll say that. And
an obvious dangerous play there on Carly Lloyd. And so the free kick for Guatemala. Diana Andrade played the full 90 the other night. Gave that ball away. Espino. De Leon. One in the air by Klingenberg. Guatemala gets a piece of that. Loses the rest. Lloyd in the circle will push it right. Allie Krieger. Blocked. Krieger rebounds and takes off with it. Upfield intended for Rapinoe. Good hard challenge there. There's another by Barrios. He was booked the other night. Maybe Barrios went in hard, and apparently too hard there. Quick free kick by Rapinoe. Trying to catch Guatemala off guard. Andrade's on the chase. Going up against Tobin Heath. Far sideline. Heath holding, cutting. Frees herself up for this chip into the box. It's deflected, and it's an easy play for Navas.
You saw a special of a player that Tobin Heath is. She's so good at just picking her head up and finding the open player, and Sydney LaRue was there, but a good play from the Guatemala defense to keep that ball from getting right to Sydney LaRue's foot.
Cat, offensively, how do you like or not like the USA spacing compared to the other night?
Well, so far it has definitely been put in their head, stay wide. Sydney LaRue tends to like to go in the middle because she does have that four mentality, but you haven't seen her yet in this game. She is staying wide, she's staying disciplined. Same with Tobin Heath, and they're able to find those players out there. Megan Klingenberg and Allie Krieger, they're making those runs. They're making it very difficult for this back five of Guatemala to handle.
Ball was lost out. Still going to belong to Guatemala. And Andrade will have another throw-in. She's from the University of South Florida. Try to play it towards the end line, and it was blocked, intended for Monterroso. Espino sends it up there, but no one in blue was making that run, and Hope Solo has probably her first touch of the game. She wasn't busy the other night, not expected to be busy tonight against a Guatemala side that we expected to play more of a bunker style. Here's Rapino. USA up by that single goal here in the 19th minute. Krieger's pass, Rapino. Open for only a moment, gave that ball away. Andrade slipping through. Good job until the end. Now the U.S. will get it back at the halfway line. Engen off Holiday, picked off Monterroso. The lead pass was cut off, intended for Solorzano. Krieger to the right, LaRue. Back to Sydney, holding. Sydney LaRue over the top. And that one gets away as well. So that pattern of unforced errors is really continuing here, especially in the more dangerous parts of the field.
Yeah, it just takes some time as you get a look at it. Looks like Andrade tried to reach out for the ball but didn't touch it with her hand, so no call. But, you know, it looks like the United States is still working on that chemistry. There's a lot of players flowing in and out of the starting lineup, a lot of players that are going to be subbed because of the high demand of this tournament. And they just haven't really figured it out yet. But the good news for the United States is there's still plenty of time before the World Cup, and they really want to start settling in on those 23 players going into the World Cup now. And they have a couple more tournaments to really see what everybody has to offer to get into the starting lineup and to make the team.
Marty Barrios with that throw-in. She'll have to do it again. Not from that spot, apparently. Maybe 5 or 6 yards or more farther back. Up the flank, Monterroso tried for it. It's deflected out. U.S. thought it was their ball. Ruled another Guatemala throw it for Barrios. Holiday. Engen. Sauerbrunn going forward. Left side, Klingenberg. Try to find Morgan in his space. That didn't work. There's a player down for the U.S. out of play on the far sideline. And the U.S. finally recognizes that and will clear it out. It's a long way across the field. Try to see who that is.
I believe it's Megan Klingenberg.
Two. Slowly getting up. The ball kept moving. I was following the ball and I noticed her out of play, so not quite sure what happened. Maybe we'll see here.
Well, it looks like the feet caught each other a little bit and maybe even a cleat to the inside of her foot, which is why she's got a little limp when she's walking back.
Klingenberg has an opportunity to make the starting 11 come June of next year. Jill Ellis wants to have more depth at the outside back position. And one would think Klingenberg is certainly in the running for it, especially based on these two starts.
Well, based on the qualifying so far, she's done a nice job, and she has a good rapport with Megan Rapinoe, who played the left side in the last game, and it'll be interesting to see how she plays with Tobin Heath on the left side in this game. It's all about relationships for those players, and they definitely want more depth, but Megan Klingenberg is definitely staking her claim as to why she should be a starter.
Kelly O'Hara has been warming up since that injury, so we'll see if a change is going to be made. Right now, it's the USA with the ball with Engen. Holiday. Pass from Heath towards the corner flag. And that's out for a USA throw in. Kept on the ground, dealt with easily, cleared up to Montanoso. U.S. recovers. Here's Rapinoe. She's tripped. Free kick for sure. Any cards? Any yellow cards coming? Nope.
Guatemala is definitely playing a lot more physical in this game from when they played against Haiti. And Megan Rapinoe does a good job of going between the double team of Guatemala, but they definitely get a foot in there and trip her up.
What do you look for, Kat, from a set piece from this distance?
We have Carly Lloyd and Megan Rapinoe on the ball. I would expect Megan Rapinoe to take it. She took the last one against Trinidad and Tobago and sailed it over. She definitely wants to try and at least get it on frame this time. She's excellent at taking free kicks, and she's dangerous.
This is from about 25 or so yards away. Rapinoe over the ball at an angle. We'll send it in right off the wall. Second try at it. Rapinoe deflected back, chipped ahead, headed across by Morgan. Guatemala clears to Espino, who grew up here in the Chicago area, went to high school, Whitney Young High School. She's broken up by Holiday. Terrific work rate from Lauren Holiday. From defense to offense. Here's the U.S. on the attack. Espino breaks it up again, loses. Lloyd looks up, chips. Jennifer Morgan, it's loose. And gathered in by Navas.
Carly Lloyd looks up and finds Alex Morgan open and wasn't able to get enough power on that head because of the position that she was coming from, and the defender was able to obstruct her a little bit from getting a good header on that.
De Leon just got clipped down, and the foul is against Carly Lloyd. De Leon was among the better players the other night for Guatemala in their match against Haiti. Tough night for Guatemala. They had an extra player in the field for about 70 minutes. Couldn't score, lost the game.
And this is the call. Looks like Carly just stepped on her foot. It's a good call from the referee. Carly didn't like it, though.
Free kick for Andrade. Daniela Andrade floats that one into the box. Not cleared out well. De Leon almost had a crack at it. Here's Espino leaving it off. Monterosso, that's blocked. She'll recover. Set forward. Awkwardly headed to the side. U.S. will try to keep it in play. Apparently they did. Rivera has that one blocked.
It's interesting for me in Guatemala. They're playing a lot of long ball. I know they want to get it out of their defensive end.
That one over the top may have surprised Sydney LaRue. She'll catch up to her by the corner flag, dropping it back. Rapinoe. Holiday. The Lloyd shot was blocked. Looks to free herself up again. Now the backheel flick didn't work. Too fancy there from Heath to Morgan. That was the attempt. Heath again, ball played across, LaRue, saved by Navas. A The flag was up and was dropped pretty quickly.
It looked like Sydney Leroux went over the back. I believe that's the call on Marilyn Rivera. It's a good ball in from Tobin Heath. Finds Sydney Leroux on the backside, but Marilyn Rivera had the position. And Sydney Leroux had to go through the player to get to the ball, and that's why there's a call. But going back to Guatemala, they're very good at keeping the ball, keeping possession, the short passes, but they're doing a lot of long ball right now, and that's not to their strength. They're not going to beat the United States in the air. They need to play short free kicks, possibly, and really try to play their style if they can.
Krieger is down. They went with the advantage call, and Ali Krieger is still down. And play is now stopped.
And this is the danger of these games. You have Guatemala just a step behind the United States when it comes to actual speed and speed of play. And they're getting their cleats in on these players, and it's dangerous. You've seen Megan Klingenberg already with her foot, and now you see Ali Krieger. I mean, cleats right into the ankle. And that is just extremely dangerous, and the referee has to take control of this because right now Guatemala can't keep up.
Are you surprised right now at the scoreline? We're almost 30 minutes into this game, and it's only a 1-0 USA lead.
Yeah, I am surprised. Honestly, the United States hasn't gotten a whole lot of opportunities, not nearly as many as they did against Trinidad and Tobago. They've finished the one of the few that they've gotten, but they, you know, are really utilizing the space a lot, but haven't really found any wide open chances. Maybe some long range shots now to kind of bring the five back out a little bit, and then they can start combining, finding those crosses in. They just haven't had enough opportunities quite yet, and that's why it's still 1-0.
USA credited with just 3 shots. Of course, the other night the story was Tamika Forbes. She made 8 saves, many of them spectacular. Heath had it taken away. U.S. looks to come back on the counter with Lloyd leading the charge. Heath cuts, finds Rapinoe. Got it to the outside, wide. End line cut back. It falls almost to Morgan. And now it's taken away instead by Andrade, and then the clearance. So again, once they get to that final third, something seems to break down for the U.S.
Well, they want to use their width, and they're doing a nice job, but don't go away from what you're really good at. You have Alex Morgan and Megan Rapinoe and Carly Lloyd right up the middle. Use them. Use each other. Play off each other well, and then find the width.
Quick free kick was taken, and they're going to bring it back.
And this is the foul called on De Leon of Guatemala, getting the better part of Carly Lloyd. And I bet the United States kind of wish they had a little more possession.
This one closer to 30 yards. And while it's in Lloyd's range, it's also in Holiday's, and it's Lauren Holiday who will take this. Chips it over the wall. The run was made by Morgan. She almost found her. It's still loose in the box. Deflected away by Guatemala. Klingenberg after it. Chased by Espino. The cut. Nice job by Klingenberg. And then that one gets away. Went out of play, came back out on the field. It's a goal kick for Guatemala. Better than a half hour gone now, Kat. Your thoughts on the way this has played out so far?
Well, it's not surprising that the United States have had all the possession in their half. I mean, Hope Solo's touched it once this whole game. And Guatemala's done a nice job to stay disciplined defensively. And the key this time around, and we talked to Jill Ellis about this, can they change on the fly? Can they change during the game? Can they make adjustments and not get frustrated like they did in Trinidad and Tobago?
Lloyd with that miss. We're talking a bit about Lauren Holiday and her role. For more on Lauren Holiday, let's go downstairs to Jenny Taft.
Well, Coach Jill Ellis told us that she really is liking Lauren Holiday in that number 6 role. She credits her vision, ability to set the tempo as a few of the reasons why she's such a good fit playing there.
And she compared her, Kat, to a player like Xabi Alonso, the great midfielder who was playing for Real Madrid, now with Bayern Munich, and of course the national team of Spain. That's the kind of player she sees Holiday becoming in that role. Upfield, Heath, into the box. Lloyd brought it down. She was pretty well defended, though, and that ball is cleared away. Engen to the outside. Holiday. Heath is wide. Morgan makes a run on the box. Heath cuts somewhat free. Morgan turns, shoots over the bar. That's her best look at goal so far tonight. She says deflection. The referee says no.
Tobin Heath had a nice first touch to beat Andrade on the sideline and then finds wide open Alex Morgan. And it definitely was tipped. It should be a corner kick. Alex Morgan is absolutely right.
5 goals in her last 6 games. She missed about 7 months with some ankle problems, but everyone says she's ready to go.
Coach Jill said she's 100% ready to go and just running on all cylinders has been extremely impressive. She said they have 5 number 9s, but Alex Morgan has done an amazing job at proving why she should be the starting center forward.
She's the name, she's the face that people will expect to see come up big in Canada come next June. Of course, the U.S. has to qualify, and everyone knows that that is really a formality, but nothing is official at the moment. Navas will put it back into play. And why not slow the game down a little bit? 15 teams have already qualified, 9 more. And a few of those teams will come now from the CONCACAF region. Guatemala upfield. No fouls called there. And now there's one. Free kick for Guatemala. Free kick coming from long distance from Andrade. Into the box it comes. One in the air by the U.S. Second ball cleared out. Rivera sends it back where it came from. Headed down to Klingenberg. And then given away again. Andrade. Way too ambitious to fire from there. Was blocked anyway. Now Solo with the distribution to the right. Ali Krieger has LaRue in front of her. Sydney LaRue will hold there. Dropping it back for Krieger. Calling everyone off is Whitney Engen. Slowing the play down. Finding Sauerbrunn. A few steps further up the field. Heath. Run being made by Lloyd. Onside, Lloyd cutting it back for Morgan. Cleared out. Should be another corner kick for the United States, this time from the farther end of the stadium.
That was good play from Tobin Heath to see that Megan Rapinoe had made the left-sided run, and Carly Lloyd was coming from a deeper role to make the run and stay onside, and that's the interchanging of these midfielder players. And I love it, Megan Rapinoe. She loves that left side, so you know she's going to tend to run that way because of how good her left foot is. But still, you're just going to see that all game is that interchange between all the midfielders.
Rapinoe's corner in swinging near post. LaRue picks it up. Back out to Rapinoe. This one off her left foot on the cross, but the flag is up. Ball sent in wide anyway. Goal kick for Guatemala. You wonder what Jill Ellis is thinking about at this point, based on what she told us the other day about the way she wanted the team to play. Are they playing that way tonight? And if not, why not?
They are playing that way. She really wanted to talk about the width.
This is a good ball over the top. The flag's up again. Offside again. And that's Morgan, who is in some discomfort after that collision. She and Barrios collided. And that's obviously not a good sign after we were just talking about how healthy Alex Morgan is.
Yeah, it's never a good sign either when the players are signaling over. That means she's in a lot of pain.
As soon as that happened, we saw Abby Wambach up and Amy Rodriguez up. So you wonder if that was the body language from the sideline indicating it was possibly serious.
Yeah, it looks like her ankle
got caught right underneath Barrios of Guatemala, and that's why she's in a lot of pain, and that was the injury that's been causing her a lot of problems. You can see her ankle just completely twist and wasn't even able to put any pressure on that ankle when she was falling down.
That's a tough sight to see Morgan down. She plays in the NWSL for the Portland Thorns, one of the stars for this team in their last gold medal triumph at the London Olympics. And normally they will call for a stretcher long before this, which makes me wonder why that's not happening, just to get her off the field. It was not a head injury, it was lower body. Right now the concern is for Alex Morgan as other players continue to warm up. Finally the stretcher, and Morgan goes off. When these two teams met in qualifying for the 2010 World Cup, U.S. won 9-0. They led 6-0 at halftime. This is a totally different game.
And what I'm seeing is true. It looks like Kristen Press is the one that's actually getting ready to go in, and Sydney LaRue would go into that center forward, that number 9 position, and Kristen Press would then come into the right winger position if Alex Morgan can't return.
Trying to read lips there on the sideline. A little difficult to do that, but right now U.S. playing with 10. Until they make that decision, they could conceivably wait, although this doesn't look good, until halftime. But that doesn't look good.
No, it doesn't look good. And honestly, you know, if it's not 100% healthy, right, there's no point in forcing it in this situation.
Risk reward, right?
Absolutely. Yeah, I'm looking. It looks like Coach Rogers is even given the card right now. They're ready to substitute right away. They don't want to risk anything even more serious for Alex Morgan.
When all is said and done, Rapinoe's going to have a free kick here. Rapinoe sent it into the box. One header was missed, and then the second ball right at goal.
Oh, Whitney Ingen made the right run, is wide open and just skims overhead. Sydney LaRue was there, but didn't have enough of her body to put on that ball and tried to dive it in, but wasn't able to. And you can see Whitney Ingen's face. She knows that she just missed that.
Well, earlier, Wambach and Rodriguez were up, but it's going to be Kristen Press who is going to get the call to come in. She's up by the fourth official. 41st minute. Is Alex Morgan headed for treatment? And let's hope that it's not serious. Holiday getting it to the outside. U.S. with just a 1-0 lead as the ball is pushed out wide. The run to the end line by Heath. Played inside, swept away by Aguilar. Klingenberg will get to it, but the flag is up again.
Well, it's interesting, during the time that Alex Morgan wasn't in the game, I can see how much Jill Ellis wants to play with. She moved Megan Rapinoe from being in that 10, that playmaker right underneath where Sydney LaRue replaces Alex Morgan, and she put her wide. She decided that she wanted Carly Lloyd and Lauren Holiday to be the two midfielders while they had 9 players on the field. And that's how much the Jill Ellis wants that width, and she really wants them to utilize it and not just force everything down the center.
So Kristen Press will come into the game as the first USA sub. And that might be a name to remember come the next World Cup. She's been an alternate before with the U.S. national team. Had a good career over in Sweden, now plays for Chicago in the NWSL, but scores at a very good rate.
She's so good with her runs in the box. She's very deceptive, but she's also extremely versatile. She gets up and down the flank extremely well. She's defensive-minded, which is something that Jill Ellis wants from those wing players. And she does connect extremely well with the outside backs.
She did start the other night. Subbed out in the second half. As that ball goes out of play for another throw-in. And you wonder what the U.S. will be thinking about at halftime if the scoreline stays like this.
Yeah, they're going to be a little bit disappointed if it does stay 1-0, even if it goes to 2-0. They wanted to score a lot of goals. They wanted to prove to themselves that the Trinidad and Tobago game, you know, just was a lot of missed opportunities and a lack of focus in the attacking third. But right now, they're not creating a lot of opportunities. You have to give credit to the defense and the discipline of Guatemala. But really, Navas in goal for Guatemala just hasn't really been tested all that much. She hasn't had to make the big saves like Kamika Forbes did of Trinidad and Tobago.
Guatemala will play it long. To me, Guatemala looks better tonight than they did against Haiti, and I thought they would look much worse tonight than they did against Haiti.
I agree. The substitutions that that Monterroso made for Guatemala have really proven to be the right ones, and they've been more dynamic. They might have not been able to play the ball through the midfield as much as they would have liked, like they did against Haiti, but they've been smarter, and they've been a lot more physical, which has given the United States a lot of problems.
Hanging up for Lloyd. Tackle away. It's a physical game. We've already seen Alex Morgan leave with an injury, but there have been several fouls in this. Aggressive tackling. Monterroso wins it back. Cleared by Aguilar. More bodies down. Lloyd will play it safely back to Engen. Sauerbrunn. Monterroso takes it away. Looking up. I think she was thinking about chipping that and then lost her footing. Final minute of this opening half. And I must say, a surprising low scoreline.
It's very surprising. Honestly, I thought the United States would come out. They did come out very hard. They scored early. But I thought the game would open up, and it really hasn't.
On this left side, Klingenberg with a cross. Kristen Press has scored. 2-0 U.S. Referee says no goal. She says no goal, offside. The flag was up. While the U.S. players were celebrating, the main referee was saying no goal.
Klingenberg plays an excellent ball in, and maybe instead of it being offside, it looked like she pushed. Rivera was.
That
can't tell from there,
look.
Yeah. But it did look like she had Kristen Press had outstretched arms against Rivera.
U.S. will play it forward towards Press, and again the flag is up. Fans are still booing that last decision. They thought Press had a legitimate goal. 3 minutes added on here into the first half. Just a one-goal lead for the United States against Guatemala. USA will have a throw-in. Engen. Monterroso's on the chase in the middle for Sauerbrunn. Walks it up slowly. Engen to Krieger. Rapinoe. Hard pass to the right for Press. Cutting it back. Krieger into the middle. Holiday. Lloyd from distance. And Navas misplaced. Allows a corner. Time running out in the half. Heath will play it short, trying to catch Guatemala off guard. Holiday, nice cut to the outside. On her left foot, she's going to earn another corner for the U.S. Holiday drives it up towards the middle. Headed down. side netting. Lloyd got up there for that. That's going to do it for the first half, with the U.S. just leading by a single goal. Pat Whitehill, your thoughts?
Well, the United States played the game plan. They played their roles a lot better than they did in the first game against Trinidad and Tobago, but they're still not capitalizing on opportunities. They didn't have as many opportunities in this game, but they're not playing through the center as much. They're playing width, but now they really need to start to play both. They have some quality players going through the midfield, combine a little bit more. They have to work on beating the bunker of Guatemala. Guatemala has been disciplined, but the United States just has to be a little bit sharper in that attacking third.
Just a 1-0 lead for the United States here at halftime. Stay tuned. Rob and friends standing by with the Continental Tire halftime report after the break.
I'm Greg Wolf here. Three things you need to know, presented by One A Day Men's 50 Plus. Fox Sports 1 NFL insider Jay Glazer reports the Seahawks have agreed to trade Percy Harvin to the Jets for a conditional mid-round draft pick. Texans linebacker Jadeveon Clowney returns to practice for the first time since undergoing arthroscopic knee surgery. Expect Clowney to be a game-time decision. And later, catch Fox Sports Live as Royals ace James Shields joins the show. That's tonight after USA Guatemala.
Lowe's presents How to Say Goodbye to 1993 Forever.
Goodbye.
Hurry into Lowe's and get Stainmaster carpet installed free by Thanksgiving.
Performance we all can appreciate. The new turbocharged Sonata Sport from Hyundai.
Did you know Heineken Light won the best tasting light beer at the 2013 World Beer Championships? Apparently there are rules about drinking beer in commercials, so I'm drinking it over here. Ah, tastes good. I'm not wearing any pants, by the way.
When 1,000 voices call out as one, ours is the world, and it's there to be won.
The General scores again and again with super low monthly payments for car insurance. Just go to thegeneral.com on your tablet, computer, or smartphone, or call us for a fast free quote. Affordable car insurance with low payments, great discounts, and a choice of payment due date. Find out how low your monthly payment can be. Get a free anonymous online quote now. For a great low rate you can get online, go to the General and save some time.
Pete Jennings won over $2 million playing fantasy sports at DraftKings.com. He's off living the high life, so we've got the next best thing. Puppets.
Hi, I'm Pete Jennings. Thanks to DraftKings.com, I've got all this money. Yeah!
Wow, playing DraftKings one-day games with your season-long team was a good idea.
Sure was. Hey, babe.
Use promo code PLAYER to play and get a free entry in the Millionaire Maker event this Sunday. Winner gets $1 million.
Louisville Slugger has been making bats since 1884 and is the official bat of Major League Baseball. They are now commemorating the Kansas City Royals' first playoff series.
Welcome back, everyone, to Toyota Park here in Bridgeview, Illinois. USA versus Guatemala, just a surprising 1-0 lead for the U.S. And they've already made a change for this start of the second half. Kelly O'Hara has come into the game replacing Allie Krieger. How does that change things, Kat?
Well, it's a much more attacking player. Kelly O'Hara in the NWSL for Sky Blue actually plays in that forward or playmaker role. So you're going to see her get forward a lot. She has a Stanford connection with Kristen Press, so their relationship is already formed. Let's see how well it's developed. So that's going to be interesting to watch this half and see how much she can get to the end line.
No changes for Guatemala. So now the USA has used two of their three subs so far. Played forward by Solorzano. Cut off. Klingenberg to the outside. Tobin Heath will take over down that flank. LaRue is on the chase. Picking it up. Cutting. The cross. Back post area. Headed across. The U.S. has their second goal. Carly Lloyd 2-0 U.S.
Well, I'd say that's a quick start that the United States was looking for in the second half. Sydney LaRue, a world-class ball to the far post. And Carly Lloyd this time doesn't foul the player, gets a clear head on the ball, and is able to finish what is a beautifully played ball from Sydney LaRue. And just heads it right back where it came from, far post. So difficult for Navas of Guatemala to handle that.
Carly Lloyd's 52nd international goal has given the U.S. a two-goal lead, and now the high pressure comes.
Well, the center forward position is a much more comfortable position for Sydney LaRue. She loves to make, to stay higher, to pressure that back line, and to make those outside runs, which you just saw, which is why she created that goal for Carly Lloyd. She's good at the wing, but she is a lot more comfortable because she's used to playing in that center forward role, and you already saw that here in the second half.
You wonder what kind of locker room discussion took place at halftime. If they weren't happy with what took place a couple of nights ago, they certainly weren't happy with the first 45 tonight.
Well, I saw Abby Wambach right before the second half kickoff really excited in the huddle for that team and probably said a lot of words to encourage the 11 that are out there right now.
Rapino to the right side. Press, give and go. Kristen Press looking, shooting off the left foot. That's over the bar. But the U.S. has come out much more attack-minded at the start of the second half.
And this is actually what we thought would happen in the first half, and they really did play a lot better in the first half than they did against Trinidad and Tobago. They didn't create as many opportunities, but they utilized the width. And now they're going fast and they're going hard, just like we talked about in the beginning. They really want to prove that they can finish and be focused in the attacking third.
Andrade. And this is where you'd think Guatemala would be more vulnerable. Both teams have had limited rest. Both teams had to travel. But with the USA's talent, their depth, and the training and medical staff, the advantage is all theirs. Here's Heath. Back heel, Rapino into the box. It'll bounce away. Holiday settles. Pushing it right side to O'Hara. Press try to receive that ball. Lloyd angles it in, intended for Heath, blocked. A much better effort for the U.S., who outshot Guatemala 8-1 in the first half. 5-0 in corner kicks, but still only had a 1-0 lead, and it's a yellow card. It's going to be given out. That's the first card of the day to LaRue.
Replay that isn't a yellow card at all for Sydney LaRue. And you can see why she's a little upset. Maybe she said something to the ref which warranted the yellow card, but by the tackle it didn't look like it should have gotten it.
Guatemala in blue losing there. Sauerbrunn. That's going to go out of play on that pass from Heath. The U.S. wants to be more precise in that first half. Several unforced errors, but also they were offside cat 6 times.
Yeah, and that's just a little bit of a lack of discipline from the United States, not knowing where the back line of Guatemala is. They have 5 players, so they're bound to stay onside. They just got a little impatient, and they can do a much better job to stay on that line.
Sauerbrunn to the middle. Engen got it wide. O'Hara. Lloyd. Much better ball movement with and without the ball. Lloyd turns. Gets it back in the left. Spins free, squares it to Rapino. Sends up ball to the outside. Press towards the end line, cut back. Block, it stays in play. Headed up, wide of goal. By LaRue. But finally, they are getting width in this game.
They are, and Kelly O'Hara, she does such a great job of getting up and down the plate. She's so fit. And it's a nicely played ball for Sydney LaRue, and she was just backing up a little bit too much, which is why she couldn't get enough on that to put it on frame.
2-0 lead for the United States over Guatemala as Monterroso breaks it up. They're going to need some possession. They can't defend the rest of the half against the U.S. team that's going for more goals, especially if fatigue sets in.
They just need a player to hold it up. If it's Maria Monterroso, number 8, or Isha Solorzano right there getting the foul, they just have to hold it up, give their defense a little bit of a break and some time to get up the field. They're so spread, or they're so defensive-minded, they really haven't gotten into the United States defensive half too much this game.
Andrade will take this free kick for Guatemala. Just a moment, we're going to get an update on Alex Morgan after this free kick is taken by Andrade. She'll send it up there, and that's going to be wide. So for more on Alex Morgan, let's get an update. Jenny Taft, what have you learned?
The official word for Alex Morgan is a left ankle sprain. She will get a scan to determine the severity, and they're not sure if that will be tonight or tomorrow.
Wow, that's the same ankle. Thank you, Jen. Kat, that's the same ankle that kept her out for some 7 months.
That's tough for Alex Morgan and this U.S. team. It's tough when you've had a recurrence of an injury so many times when it keeps happening, a sprained ankle. It causes you to have surgery, and you hope that's not the case for Alex Morgan.
Here's Monterroso. Espino in the middle, right in the circle, broken up by Heath, who scored the first goal for the U.S. Hard running there from LaRue. The U.S. have picked up in their intensity, no question about that here in the second half. LaRue is on it, dropping it back. It's headed for Klingenberg. Lloyd will pick it up. Lloyd's pass blocked by Espino. Monterroso. That's blocked by LaRue. Tackle by Andrade. Kept in play up the wing. No option there. Engen will play it back safely to Solo. Laid off by O'Hara. Sauerbrunn, Holiday. It's not on, so she'll settle it down. Now she finds Rapinoe. Soft touch to Lloyd. Then a ball played to the right side, and just too much on it. But the idea was right. This is much better in the second half from the U.S.
I absolutely love that play from the United States. They were going down the center. Lauren Holiday, Megan Rapinoe, Carly Lloyd, and then they went to the outside. They just missed the final ball. But that's what you want to see in that midfield. You start central and then go wide. That's what Jules loves right there.
It's a learning curve for this U.S. team, no doubt. New coach in place. With Jill Ellis taking over earlier this year for Tom Sormani. Here on this left side, Heath against Andrade. Gets to the end line, back post area, and that's over the bar on top of the netting. Goal kick coming up.
Good play from Tobin Heath, beating her with one touch, but just wasn't able to keep the ball and bounce and square her hips quite enough to get into play.
Kelly O'Hara will pick this ball up, keeping it on the ground, right sideline towards Kristen Press. That's blocked by Guatemala. Sent long to Monterroso. She was detained, no foul given. Holiday. Rapinoe cutting. She got around Rencinos to the right wing. Cuts by Press. End line. Tackled out. Corner U.S.
This is great technical ability from Kristen Press. Beats the defender once, beats her twice. And that's good cover from Barrios for Guatemala to get the corner kick for the United States.
The corner from Rapino. She'll drive it across, headed once, and then cleared away by De Leon. She gives it away. Rapino again, that's blocked as well. Another USA corner. Rapino's been taking them all tonight. She'll drive it across. Back post area, flicked in. 3-0 U.S. I believe Tobin Heath flicked that ball. That will be her second goal of the night.
The corner kick from Megan Rapinoe is perfectly struck. Line drive, and Carly Lloyd does a nice job of keeping it low and putting it across, and Tobin Heath, what a fun flick, able to get the goal. And this is what you want to do when you're in the corner kick areas, frame the ball, frame the goal, so you can get any kind of flick, because there's so many bodies in there. And look at there, that's a lot of fun to watch.
Tobin Heath has two goals, USA has three, and there's the first attempt at Hope Solo from De Leon. But things opened up with that goal by Carly Lloyd about a minute into this half, setting the tone. This is not the way the game started, even though the U.S. scored in the fifth minute. LaRue pushing forward, that's blocked. Foul on Guatemala, free kick USA.
The United States has just worn Guatemala down. You can tell that Guatemala is just not 90 minutes fit. They're slow with the speed of play. They just haven't caught up yet, and the United States is finally capitalizing in the second half.
Free kick, Rapino. Teasing ball in, the header, and another goal. Whitney Engen. Her third international goal. Great service by Rapino.
It's another perfect ball from Megan Rapino, and Whitney Engen did not miss this one. She missed one earlier in the first half, but she headed this so well, stayed onside. And when you have a ball played like that, all you have to do is redirect it towards the goal. And that's exactly what Engen did, and that's why she scored.
A 4-0 lead now for the United States. It was 1-0 at the end of the first half. Early goal by Lloyd certainly changed things. Played back by Tobin Heath. Holiday. And that one's behind a couple of players, but it's kept in play by Heath. Sauerbrunner into the middle. Into the circle, it goes to Engen. Rapino. Holiday beating two, taken down, no foul call. Thought she was going to get a free kick from just outside the box. Here's Lloyd, avoiding one tackle, getting it through, then she gets taken down. Free kick here for the United States. In almost the same spot that I thought a free kick was going to be awarded moments ago.
Absolutely. Well, this referee needs to get control of the match. There's been a lot of injuries. Carly Lloyd does a nice job of beating the first defender. And absolutely, Barrios gets a clip on Carly Lloyd. I'm kind of surprised they didn't give the United States advantage.
Free kick for the United States, about 24 yards away from goal. Lloyd behind the ball. Ready to strike on the whistle. Chips it over the wall. Thought Navas got a piece of it, apparently not. At the top of the crossbar. Now they're going to change that. It is a corner. Initial signal was a goal kick. Rapino will take it. This one goes short for the first time. Holiday fights to win it. Back to Rapinoe from O'Hara. She's denied that space. Rivera picks it up. Rapinoe wants it more. At the end line, trying to turn U.S. much more scrappy in this second half, contesting every ball, being the aggressor.
I was just about to say that in the first half, they were beautiful soccer and they were playing extremely well. Well, now they're still playing beautiful soccer, but there's double teams and triple teams. They're bringing the physicality that Guatemala brought to them in the first half. They're bringing it right back, and it's proven to be extremely successful.
Lloyd turns, still has it. Lloyd fires low, and it's just wide. LaRue is making the run as well, trying to get a deflection perhaps on that ball.
Well, Carly Lloyd is so good at the long range shot, but she just got the inside of her foot, which is why she didn't get enough power behind it.
Cleared upfield by Navas. LaRue, again, just outworking everyone. U.S., no question, a much better conditioned team, and we're starting to see that even more so now.
Well, absolutely, and Sydney LaRue, her change of speed is so fun to watch, because when she wants a ball, she decides to get it, she can get there pretty quickly, and her high pressure from that center court position is so annoying to any back line.
Rapinoe with a corner kick from the near sideline. U.S. up 4-0 over Guatemala. Sent towards the back post. Headed once. Holiday trying to position herself to get that. Does. Chipped into the box. One header misses. It's coming all the way back. Pushed to the side. Rapinoe from Klingenberg. Tobin Heath. Couple of goals on the night. That's tackled away. And just a goal kick, apparently.
Another thing that's different in this second half is there hasn't been a lot of unforced errors. They've really been clicking on all cylinders. They're connecting well. The chemistry is there. They're seeing each other. The runs that are being made, they're being made early. They're not reacting. They're anticipating. And that's the difference so far from the first half to the second half.
Holiday. O'Hara under some pressure. Holiday from Engen to the outside. Picked up by Heath. Rapinoe. LaRue. This is ball movement that we didn't see in the first half, but at least not that much of it. Another free kick to the U.S.
This is the foul called against Tobin Heath. And see why Solorzano is a little upset by that. It didn't look like much. Tobin Heath was smart just to go down and get the call.
On the last Rapinoe free kick, USA was able to score on a goal by Engen. This from a much deeper angle. She'll drive it across. And that's headed over. The corner kick for the United States. This time, Lauren Holiday's going to go over to take it, and Rapinoe will get in another spot on the field. Holiday with a short corner. Rapinoe back for Lauren Holiday. Looks to drive it across. One header. Navas came off the line. It's out. And it should be a goal kick. Tobin Heath with a couple of goals tonight. Her first two-goal game in a USA uniform.
This is the long ball from Lauren Holiday. Finds Sydney LaRue's head, and Tobin Heath unable to keep it going. But still, that far post ball against this small Guatemala team is so dangerous for the United States.
Goal kick for Navas. The U.S. will get that ball back. LaRue fights for it. Lloyd towards LaRue. Boy picks it up. Still. It's blocked. Rapino shot. Rapino scores. 5-0 USA.
Ricochets and one times it from Megan Rapinoe, and that is what makes Megan Rapinoe so brilliant, are these shots where she can just curl it in and finish it so easily.
Terrific shot by Rapinoe, but the work rate of Lloyd to keep that ball alive, to keep things going, the offensive third, was impressive. What a difference here in the second half. Holiday, it's a 5-0 lead now for the USA over Guatemala. Press on the right, cutting towards that middle. She wanted Lloyd. It's blocked by Espino, but Holiday picks it up. Give and go, too much on the give intended for Holiday. It's a goal kick for Navas.
But you're really starting to see Lauren Holiday getting forward a lot more. She didn't go forward nearly this much against Trinidad and Tobago, but you're starting to see that position evolve for Lauren Holiday. It's starting to click with her that, yeah, maybe she starts from a defensive role, but she still needs to get forward because of how good she is on that final pass.
And Amy Rodriguez is going to come into the game. And she's replacing Klingenberg. So obviously they're not going to swap positions. How will this change the look of the U.S.?
Well, Amy Rodriguez will now go kind of into that number 10 role, that playmaker role, and Megan Rapinoe, who was in that playmaking role, will go to the left side, and Tobin Heath will actually get into some defensive areas and play in that outside position, which is a little bit new for the United States.
When we were on replay, I saw Tobin Heath go to the sideline and get some words from Jill Ellis, so that must have been, get ready for this, coming up soon, we're going to make this change and you're going to go back there.
I wonder if Jill Ellis had told Tobin Heath, we might want to try you here. They are still looking for that depth in that outside position. And Tobin Heath, it could be an excellent option because of how good she is at going forward and how creative she is on the ball. And her and that winger could have a really good relationship connecting and getting that combination play on that flank.
O'Hara to the halfway line. 69th minute. USA leading 5-0 over Guatemala. More of the scoreline we thought we might have, but earlier than this. It's only 1-0 at halftime. Left sideline for Tobin Heath. Up now from the left back spot. Rapinoe. Cutting. Driving it across. Right at goal. Almost spilled by Navas, but she holds on. Rapinoe's played just about everywhere tonight, hasn't she?
She really has. She's been all over the field. And what makes her so special is when she does cut in that right foot and bend it in, just like she did on the goal, just that quick little move and wasn't able to get enough height on it. But still, it's so dangerous.
Settled by Sauerbrunn. Pushed ahead. Holiday. Here's that vision, that precision on the pass to Heath. Lost out for a corner kick. And Rapinoe's going to take another.
Another thing about Tobin Heath coming into the game at left back is it gives Megan Klingenberg that break. There's, like we've been talking about, that high demand of this tournament, the quick turnaround. And now Megan Klingenberg, who is asked to get forward a lot, get up and back, can rest some of those legs and look forward into the rest of the tournament.
So Lozano will leave. First substitution for Guatemala, Kellen Mayen will come in. Corner for Rapinoe on that whistle. To the middle. Cleared out of the box. Stepping up, settling it is Sauerbrunn. O'Hara on the run. Head up, into the box. The delivery, chested down. That was Press. It comes back outside off the chest of Rapino for Tobin Heath. Rapino. Heath. All the way across to O'Hara. She continued and then was taken down. Free kick, USA. Another one of those players that started out collegially as a good goal scorer up top at Stanford. It's been converted since to the back and play either outside back position. Holiday, free kick into the box for Pino's header. It's wide. First I thought she was going for goal, but she might have been going for Rodriguez at the back post.
Amy Rodriguez was making that far post run, and my guess is Megan Rapinoe is probably going to goal. That's probably her mindset, but Amy Rodriguez was framing extremely well, and just one more step and she could have gotten onto the end of it. And you can see the frustration from Megan Rapinoe.
Rapinoe trying to bring it down. Holiday. O'Hara. West still attacking. Press, that's blocked. Holiday. Heath, and that's blocked as well. Rodriguez, Holiday to the outside for Press. Trying to go wide. The assistant referee on that far side says that's a foul on Kristen Press.
Definitely looks like the both got tangled with each other. The crowd doesn't like the call, but the referee decided that Kristen Press reached out just a little bit too much, which is why Rivera went on the ground and she gets the call.
74th minute, U.S. over Guatemala. 5-0 is the scoreline. Tobin Heath with a couple of goals. Lloyd has one, Engen has one, Rapinoe has one for the United States. Heath, Rapinoe into the middle for Holiday, who continues to playmake from deep. Into the box, played back. Could Heath get three? She was blocked. Out to Rapinoe. Driven ball into Press. She went backwards and she made that connection. Guatemala tries to clear heavy USA pressure. All the momentum riding the USA's way ever since they scored early in this half. Guatemala getting ready to make their final two substitutions of the night.
Honestly, I'm a little surprised it's taken Monterosa so long to make these substitutions. This team is so tired right now for Guatemala.
Just been defending this whole half. Into the box. It's intended for Press. Chipped into the box. The run was made by LaRue, but it's caught by Navas. USA with a commanding 5-0 lead here in the 75th minute from Toyota Park in Bridgeview, Illinois. Rodriguez leaving it. Carly Lloyd got it to the outside. O'Hara up from the right back spot for Kristen Press. Back to O'Hara. Somewhat free at the end line. Teasing ball in is blocked. US looking to get it back. Press lost it there. Finally a touch from Guatemala, but they can't keep possession. Out of gas. It's taken too long to get the subs in. Ball still in the field of play. Rapinoe gets some tired defenders into the box. Over it goes, and now we'll finally see the ball out for the double substitution. De Leon is going to be one of the players coming out. Aguetta's coming into the game, and Barrera. Is the referee? Now she is going to acknowledge it. It's taken a while, but she's acknowledging. De Leon out. Alida Argueta is coming into the game. She did not play the other night against Haiti. Barrera did as a starter. And it's going to be Maria Monteroso who's coming up. And some of the other tired players can maybe rest up a little bit. As that substitution, double substitution, took a little bit. Rapino went short again. Heath. Nice cut again. Tried to drive it across. Tobin Heath back in the ball. And the flag is up. You talked about Tobin Heath at the start of the game. She's been very impressive tonight, not just because of the two goals, but all around play.
Yeah, absolutely. She's utilized the width extremely well for the United States. She's been really good at changing speed, but also at holding the ball up for the United States. She's played well connecting with Megan Rapinoe and Sydney Leroux up there. And now she's been impressive as a left back that we're not so accustomed to seeing her playing. But she's been getting forward, and she's just so technically gifted on the ball. She's fun to watch whenever she has the ball at her feet.
Kick for Guatemala in her own half. Andrade's over the ball. She'll send this one long. And even on that own free kick, they were unable to keep possession. Now they must defend again. And a ball played down the left sideline. A jersey tug by Andrade as the two number twos got together. Back here from LaRue. A little showtime now here in Illinois.
That wasn't a little jersey tug. That was a big jersey tug. I'm surprised they gave advantage for that one as Sydney Leroux got held up.
Off the throw in for Holiday. Intended for Rodriguez. Barrera intercepted. Holiday from Lloyd. Drives it. Just wide of Navas. It's a much more confident looking USA side as well. No doubt those goals helped them out at the start of the half.
Absolutely. The very early goal from Carly Lloyd just really settled the team down. They knew that they could break this team down at some point, and to break them down within the minute of the opening second half, it just kind of had a sense of relief for this team. And now they can play the way that they've been wanting to play this whole tournament. And we're really seeing that on both sides of the ball, offensively and defensively, they've really put it all together.
The only negative on this night, the injury, ankle injury, left ankle injury to Alex Morgan. Find out more about that in the days ahead. Here's Carly Lloyd. Cutting. Shooting. Wide. It was Lloyd's goal at the start of this half that got the USA started.
Yeah, and she's been so dynamic on and off the ball, and this time just trying to dribble and give a little cheeky ball to Sydney Leroux, but just went a little too far. But her and Lauren Holiday are really starting to understand their roles in the midfield and play really well off of each other.
We talked about Holiday, and you said as time evolves, go farther up the field. I know that's what Jill Ellis wants, but I think we've seen her go farther up the field even more today than we thought.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, she's been up there dribbling, playmaking, and she's even getting some shots on goal, which is what they want to see from her because of how dangerous she is as a goal scorer and playmaker. And if they can keep getting her to go forward like this, I mean, this team could really be unstoppable if Lauren Holiday can keep evolving that position they put her in so far.
Amy Rodriguez on the far side. Had a great season with FC Kansas City. Scored in the playoffs as well as 13 goals in the regular season. Goes against Amy Rodriguez. Guatemala will have a free kick.
And looked a lot like shoulder-to-shoulder contact. Probably better to have a no-call against Amy Rodriguez in that situation. Would have been a goal kick anyway, so would have just been better just to keep the whistle down.
Sauerbrunn for Tobin Heath. Into the middle for Holiday, receives it well to free herself up for that angle for the pass. Just too far for press. Holiday's either been on the money tonight or very close on those passes.
Honestly, I thought Kristen Press was going to catch that ball because that really was an excellent long ball service from Holiday. And you're right, she's either extremely close or absolutely perfect.
U.S. wins another ball. Here's Rapinoe in the box. Inside, one flick towards Press. Played across and it goes over. U.S. almost had a sixth.
Megan Rapinoe, how many assists is she going to have today, or almost? And Sydney LaRue doesn't typically miss those balls. She tried to, instead of just heading it hard, she tried to flick it on a little bit too much, which is why she missed it.
Navas clears. Coming all the way back, Sauerbrunn back to solo. Crowd is cheering just because she's not really touched the ball here in the second half, and maybe only once in the first half. Moment this left side, Sauerbrunn. All of the action this half has been in this half of the field. Holiday drives that one towards LaRue, headed into the middle. Lloyd gave it up unselfishly to LaRue. Sydney LaRue will play it back. Rapinoe into the box towards Press. She got together with Lloyd. I think they each took each other off of that play. Now the flag is up on that far side. If anything, the U.S. team was very, very unselfish there. Maybe too unselfish.
Exactly. And just a little miscommunication in the box between Kristen Press and Carly Lloyd. They might have had the goal. I don't think that's a foul at all on Carly Lloyd. I know Barrios is upset, but just good physical play in my opinion.
Yes, certainly passed up at least a couple of shots there. Up by a 5-0 score. Another foul is called on the U.S. We said before it was, has been, throughout. Very physical game, and not just because of the Alex Morgan injury, which didn't seem like a lot of contact compared to some of what we've seen here tonight. There's no give there on either player.
Yeah, another no call, and I know that Barrios is probably just really tired, which is why she's going down a lot easier.
On the far side of the field, it was lost. Guetta will have a throw in. For Espino. Guatemala will send it back the other way. And the U.S. is able to corral that. Tobin Heath. Sauerbrunn turning his Holiday. 85th minute. All USA at this point with a 5-0 lead. Four goals in the second half against Guatemala. USA will take on Haiti on Monday in Washington, D.C. Guatemala meets Trinidad and Tobago. Kristen Press loads up the left foot. High and wide of Navas.
And you can see all the excitement from all the players. They're happy, they're having fun, and you can just see it out here today that they're all smiles because it's just been beautiful soccer from everyone, and I love this from Whitney Ingen. Not many, you don't get many opportunities to center back, so you're excited when you see someone like Ingen scoring.
Spoken like someone who knows that very well, in fact, as this ball is cleared upfield. We didn't see those smiles the other night against Trinidad and Tobago, so it's good that they're able to do that here this evening. They were not happy with their play the other night, neither was the coaching staff. And I would say the same with the first half tonight.
They played better in the first half than they did in the game against Trinidad and Tobago by far, but this second half has just been a clinic, and this is exactly what Jill Ellis wanted to see from her team, and knowing their different roles and playing them well.
Holiday spreading it around towards Press. Look at that burst of speed. Press in the box, looking, shooting, stopped by Navas. Created her own chance off the dribble. Sent up field by Guatemala. Barrera. Drop back, Espino. And another giveaway from Guatemala. That's another reason why they're doing so much defending. They can't hold the ball the few times they've had it.
And it doesn't help when you have to hold the ball against excellent center backs and Becky Sauerbrunn and Whitney Ingen. It's just, it's so difficult and your team is so tired. And even if you were to hold the ball up, how much help would you really get? They're just not coming up with their attacking players.
Pushing forward, Holiday keeping it on the ground. Lloyd fought to get on the end of that ball, take it down. When I say it's a physical game, forget the foul count. How about the fouls that were not called tonight?
Yeah, it's been interesting. You know, you want the referee to protect every player, but it seems like she almost is protecting Guatemala a little bit more than the United States, and it's caused some injury issues for the United States as a couple players have gone down.
LaRue after that ball, it's cleared. Banged ahead by Mayan. And the U.S. will collect it in the 88th minute. Engen, who has one goal tonight, up for Holiday. Sauerbrunn. For LaRue, held up there by Monterosso. Cut off there in the back, blocked. And the box swept away by Aguilar. Rivera's on the chase, as is Press. Rivera does well to clear it, but gave it right back to Holiday. First pass complete to Heath. And that ball is given away. That's one of the rare giveaways this half for the U.S. compared to the first half. Solo out of goal again. Pushed over to the right sideline. O'Hara. Rodriguez, Kristen Press. In the 89th minute, the U.S. with a 5-0 lead over Guatemala. Holiday inching forward, edge of the box, still with it. Try to slip that ball through, blocked by Barrera. She was still trying to create.
Yeah, I think she got a little bit wide-eyed on that one, hoping to kind of dribble the whole back line of Guatemala, one of the few mistakes from Lauren Holiday. But still, she's getting forward, and that's what they want to see.
Nice ball in for LaRue. She tried to cut it back. Pressure there from Lloyd. And now it's Andrade. Nowhere to go for her. Knocked out. U.S. touched it last. Goal kick for Navas. In the 90th minute. Tobin Heath with a couple of goals tonight. Lloyd, Engen, and Rapinoe had the others in a night where the U.S. was able to rest Christy Rampone and Abby Wambach. Again, the only bad mark on the night. Alex Morgan left the game with what appears to be a left ankle injury. Left late in the first half. 3 minutes added on here in stoppage time as Rodriguez picks up this ball, lays it off. O'Hara in the middle. Got it outside, wide for Kristen Press. Driven across, and that's too far. LaRue was after that ball as Press drove it across. And one of their keys tonight, they certainly added width to their game. They were playing too narrow, Jill Ellis said, against Trinidad and Tobago. That has not been the case tonight, especially in the second half.
No, not at all. They've done an excellent job of getting the width, going to the end line, being creative in the attacking third. They've really done a nice job of also going down the middle, which they did so well in parts in the Trinidad and Tobago game. So they've, you know, really changed it up a lot. They've just been a lot more creative in the as a whole, and that's why they've scored 5 goals and had a lot more opportunities in the second half.
And the finishing has been better as well. They almost had 30 shots the other night, but only connected on one. Rapinoe. Heath. There's Rapinoe, Lloyd, and LaRue cut off by Andrade. That's blocked. The U.S. still working hard here at the end, even in stoppage time with a 5-0 lead.
That's just the United States mentality. You never stop. You go the full 90 in the stoppage time. It's still an evaluation process, too, for the World Cup, so you want to keep going and keep proving yourself.
It's going to be competitive for the starting 11 for sure. You can take 23, though, to the World Cup, 20 on this tournament roster. That's going to do it. Final whistle, USA with a much more convincing performance, Kat, and a 5-0 win for Jill Ellis, Team USA.
Well, the United States came out in the second half and met the physicality of the Guatemalan team, and Guatemala just couldn't handle it. United States scored early, and they just became a lot more creative in the attacking third, and that's why they got a lot more opportunities and more goals.
Tobin Heath, one of the stars of the night. She had a couple of goals, one in the 7th minute, at least unofficially, and the other in the 57th minute. Carly Lloyd also scored in the game. Whitney Engen scored, as did Megan Rapinoe. So the only down spot of the night, the injury to Alex Morgan, who left the game in the first half play. So, Rob, other than the injury to Alex Morgan, it seems like the USA is back on track based on the second half performance. 5-0 win over Guatemala.
JP, Kat, thank you. Remember, 4 years ago at this tournament, the U.S. took care of Guatemala 9-0. Today, it was 5-0. Finally, the U.S. kind of back on track, what we expected to see from them, our cast of characters here. We're going to continue talking about this game up next on Fox Sports Live. And, of course, one of the main talking points is going to be the first half injury to Alex Morgan. She sat out about 7 months up until June with a left ankle injury, and it has resurfaced. But the U.S. now on top of Group A with 6 points. Fox Sports Live is next, where we will continue our coverage of the Alex Morgan injury and the United States victory. Full highlights and post-game sound will kick off the show. Plus, the guys will also feature a story on Jamaica. The Ray Day girls, despite a challenging build-up to this tournament, have put themselves in wonderful position to get to their first Women's World Cup. We'll see you next.
Hey, that's Omar Bravo. Hey, Omar.
Hi, I'm Rob Lowe, and I have DirecTV.
And I'm super creepy Rob Lowe, and I have cable.
With DirecTV, you get 99% signal reliability.
Now that's reliable. My cable's out, so I'm down at the rec center watching folks swim.
I love that I can watch my shows and be worry-free.
And I love the smell of other people's hair.
Don't be like this me. Get rid of cable and upgrade to DirecTV. Call 1-800-DIRECTV.
What's for lunch, America? That's easy. Golden Corral's new $7.99 lunch deal. It's the fastest lunch in town, and there's something for everyone. It's nonstop appetizers, entrees, our endless salad bar, and our new Las Vegas-style desserts. It's our $7.99 endless lunch, and it's only at Golden Corral.
What are you doing here, Private Esparza?
Getting strong, Drill Sergeant!
Why are you here, Private Cochran?
To be a soldier, Drill Sergeant!
What are you doing here?
Training to be a graphic artist, Drill Sergeant!
You join the world's greatest army
to become a graphic artist?
Outstanding! Now that's a man with a plan!
With unmatched training and over 150 careers that give you options beyond the battlefield, there are over 150 ways to become Army strong. Find yours at GoArmy.com/defy.
Okay, here's the plan. You're
going to want to turn right. In 0.2 miles.
Watch the lane.
And we have this really great view.
Got a car in our blinds.
Salsa dance.
He was dancing.
Mm-hmm. Backseat drivers just met their match. Introducing the entirely new Sonata Sport.
You forgot to turn off the...
From Hyundai.
This is Phyllis. Phyllis is headed to a science conference, so she's not thinking about winter tires right now. But if she were, all she'd need to know is TireRack.com. Right now, she could receive a Bridgestone Winter Utility Kit after mail-in rebate when she buys a set of four qualifying Blizzak tires. For details, she'd go to TireRack.com/TV. But Phyllis isn't thinking about tires. Phyllis is thinking, well, I'm not really sure, but it's probably important. TireRack.com. Find, deliver, install.
For over 150 years, the Bacardi family has made the world's most awarded rum. Bacardi, untamable since 1862.
Terrible. Two dudes in suits talking sports. Welcome to Fox Sports Live. I'm Don Bell, kicking it with Ryan Field. Kansas City is headed to the World Series for the first time in 29 years. We have an exclusive interview with Royals ace James Shee.
That plus an amazing story on One Nation soccer team trying to defy the odds and make the Women's World Cup. But first, Rob Stone and Company standing by with more on the U.S. women's matchup with Guatemala. Rob?
All right, thanks, guys. So three dudes in suits, two ladies looking nice in dresses, Rob Stone, Heather Mitz, Eric Winalda, Leslie Osborne, the good doctor, Dr. Joe Maknik, back here with you. Remember, 2 days ago, the U.S. opened up World Cup qualifying in this CONCACAF tournament with a less than convincing 1-0 victory in Kansas City over Trinidad and Tobago. Today, they were in Chicago taking on Guatemala. Got that early goal, Eric, that they really needed. It came in the seventh minute, courtesy of Tobin Heath.
It's a gritty goal. It's brave because, you know, it's never going to be offsides in a million years. Great little touch. But her bravery gets her a goal.
And great way to start the game.
Absolutely. This, not so great. 37th minute, Alex Morgan. Watch that left ankle.
This is something she had already been coming back from, finally getting her confidence, healthy out there on the field. You hate to see this happen.
So she was subbed out. And brought in the 42nd minute was Kristen Press. And Kristen Press thought she had a goal here, Dr. Joe, in the 45th.
Now, the assistant referee had the flag up, and it's clearly not an offside decision. The player being behind the ball the whole time, so had to be called as a foul. And we've seen many goals scored where the player goes over and out to head the ball for a goal.
Leslie, wonderful start for the second half here. LaRue to Carly Lloyd.
Well, this is a beautiful goal, and this is the way you want to start a second half. You know at halftime that Coach Ellis and all the girls said, score early, and this is a great way to start the half.
So that made it 2-0, 57th minute, Eric, 3-0. Love the cheeky back heel here.
This is fantastic. I mean, you get yourself in those little positions, and you got to be creative, and that's what we saw out of her tonight. There was a couple times where she went for that back heel. She got her chance in front of the net, and it was a great goal.
That is classic Tobin Heath, by the way.
Yeah, and it looks like everyone's having fun out here in the second half.
Sure, when you're scoring goals.
Yeah.
Goal after goal. There's Whitney Engen there to make it 4-0, 66th minute, Rapinoe. We saw her sky one of these in game one. This one is pretty finishing here, Heather.
Once again, classic Megan Rapinoe, you know, bending the ball away from the goalkeeper. I mean, that's a beautiful goal.
Remember, one of the goals for the manager, Jill Ellis, coming to this tournament, not to concede a goal. So far, so good for the U.S. 1-0 victory. Now tonight, a 5-0 win. The U.S. all alone on top of Group A, but they have yet to secure one of those top two spots that'll put them in the semifinals. They're back in action Monday at RFK Stadium in Washington, D.C. But the big takeaway of this one, besides the three-point win, Alex Morgan, an 07, partially tore her ACL, missed 5 months. In 2013, left ankle stress reaction is what they called it, missed roughly 7 months, and then the ugliness of that left ankle injury in the first half today. Jenny Taft caught up with U.S. manager Jill Ellis just after the game.
Thanks so much. Well, Jill, the offensive production was there tonight. What stood out to you the most about your team's performance?
I mean, I think just the way we sprayed the ball around, we got more combinations wide. You know, again, I thought Chaney had a brilliant game pushing the ball around. Tempo was better. You know, and I think we talked about halftime, really trying to get deeper on our crosses, look for the back post, and we resulted in that. So I was just overall really pleased and obviously building momentum.
Tobin Heath had a great game for you tonight with two goals. You told me she'd been great in training. What was the best thing you saw from her performance?
I mean, just her ability to combine and keep the ball, and she's just so creative. You know, we were able to get a lot of production from our left side, mainly because her and Klingenberg and Pino created a lot of 3v2s out there. So, yeah, she had a great night.
Any update on Alex Morgan? Never good to see her go down.
Yeah, I mean, hopefully we don't think it's too bad right now. Obviously, we'll get x-rays on her and hope for the best, but we're hoping she'll be fine.
All right, thanks for your time. Congrats.
Thank you.
Guys?
Heather, let's start with you as we talk about Alex Morgan. You've been a teammate with her. You know her on the field, in the locker room as well. What does her absence mean to this U.S. team?
Well, I mean, the team depends on her now, you know, for someone that can come on the field and score a lot of goals for her, for them. The combinations that they have with Abby Wambach, you know, it's something that this team will miss dearly. If she does have an injury, it's going to keep her out for the World Cup.
True, and again, this is an opportunity for all the other players to step up, and she is a huge part of this team, but there's so many other players that are going to contribute and step up and that are leaders on the field, too.
That's what I saw tonight. I mean, I saw a team that got hit, saw their star get hurt, but they played better. They played better soccer once she was off the field. I hate to say that, but if you watch the way that they played, everybody understood to get it, move it. Jealous actually touches on that the team played better once there was not a star, and the team became the star. It was kind of cool to watch.
How does this impact them, Leslie, going forward?
The injury?
Yes.
Let's hope for the best for her. The team is going to continue to grow upon this game. They had a much better second half. They're going to continue on their momentum. Other players are going to step up and get minutes, but right now they're feeling a lot better, and they're going to come out and have a great next game.
I agree with what Eric was saying, that the team played better once Alex was out of the game, but, you know, they do have a lot of depth on this roster, yeah. But I do think that they need Alex Morgan on this team.
Absolutely.
And but I just became a Tobin Heath fan, I'll tell you that. Anybody that can do back heels and score like that and is unafraid to play and is inventive, it was fun to watch. I really enjoyed watching her play tonight.
Well, teams have to really watch out for Alex, so whether she's on the field or not, she is such a threat out there, and teams have to change the way they play against the U.S. when she's on the field.
Yes.
Dr. Joe, I want to turn things to you. In the pregame, we said, you know what? We had some trepidation coming into this tournament about the officiating pool. They've done all right so far. This match, how would you rate the officiating?
It's tough to criticize a referee in a 5-0 game, but if the assistant referee's flag was up for offside on the play that Alex Morgan got hurt, and that whistle didn't blow quickly for the offside and players continue to play and that's where the injury happened, then there's a contribution factor of the officiating team to that injury.
Good for you.
Contribution factor. That's the first time that you always have an
idea. Hey, that's what doctors do. That makes fun.
Trademark it quickly, Dr. Joe. Trademark it quickly. So the United States on top of Group A, the only team in Group A on 6 points. They're on the cusp of moving on to the semifinals. Group B activity fires back up tomorrow at 4 and then 6 Eastern. Another doubleheader. Mexico in the late game. They lost game one. A lot of concern for Mexico right now. Guys, let's send it back to you.
All right, Rob, thank you. Small country, but a big impact in sports. From Usain Bolt to the bobsledding team, Jamaica has a way of making noise in international competition. The women's soccer team has overcome numerous obstacles and is poised to make some history. They've already made a huge impression by dominating their first CONCACAF match 6-0. The team calls itself the Reggae Girls, and they're ready to make some music on the pitch.
I remember the first time I ran out in my jersey with my name on my back. That feeling is unlike any other. When someone would ask, do you play for your country? It would be like, I think I do.
I didn't really have hope that it was gonna come back. You're not so sure what you are working towards. It's like a loss of hope. Hope has been restored.
It was like a big family reunion when they came back together.
A bunch of characters on this team, a lot of personality.
They're like the sisters I never had.
When it was brought to my attention that these girls really had a chance,
But there was a lack of funding. I just thought that it was something that I could lend my voice to. Daddy was a football player. Two things he would always have is a football and his guitar. Football, that's his second love.
I thought she was just gonna come and provide us with stuff we need. But our first tournament, she was at every single game, and she stood up and cheered throughout the entire game. She's like a sister figure, an auntie figure, you know?
The sponsors weren't backing them. You know, you still have this woman, that's not where you should be. You should not be kicking a football.
Just saying that girls can't play football. It's a man's sports. We get that in Jamaica a lot.
Imagine playing for your country and you're getting no recognition, no support. You feel like you're going out there to represent 2.8 million people who don't want to be represented. That was how we would feel. But now, we feel like everybody's behind us.
The response has been overwhelming.
You feel like you're not alone. We've never been able to have a camp outside of Jamaica. But now that has changed, you can see, you know, the difference.
We're getting training that we never got before. We have a much better chance right now than we did back then.
Their speed is ridiculous. It's like you have like little Usain Bolts out there with a football.
We're coming from not existing for like 6 years and now on the verge of creating history.
It's a movie waiting to happen. To be the first Caribbean country to be in the World Cup.
It's unfathomable.
All the girls in Jamaica, I think it will be humongous. It'll be huge.
Young girls coming up and say, and they look at us and they say, wow, I can do this someday.
You don't have to be what society deemed you to be.
With hard work and dedication,
anything is possible.
That's all they want to do, play football. We're giving them the chance to do that. I'm just happy to be a part of it. Everybody's in love with the reggae girls.
Bob Marley, Usain Bolt, it's a small country, but we make big impact. It's time for the female footballers to put our mark on the world. So we're here.
Now with the support of a nation and actual team funding to help them prepare, the Reggae Girls are finally able to show the world what they're capable of. And you can follow Team Jamaica's quest when they take on Costa Rica Saturday at 4 p.m. Eastern on Fox Sports 2.
Percy Harvin needs to look no further than Brandon Marshall to see how a change in scenery can do wonders for your reputation. As first reported by our own Jay Glazer, the Seahawks and Jets agreed to a deal Friday that sends Harvin to New York in exchange for a conditional draft pick in 2015. Harvin brings his athleticism, injury tendencies, and his oftentimes up-and-down personality to a team whose coach has plenty of it. Harvin will join his third NFL team after being drafted by the Vikings back in 2009. He's just 26 years old, but has played in only 15 games over the last three seasons due to a variety of ailments. It's a low-risk move for the Jets, as his contract is only guaranteed through this season. Harvin's career in Seattle never really got off the ground. After becoming one of football's most electrifying players in Minnesota, he recorded only one regular season touchdown with the Seahawks, and his yards per reception were nearly cut in half with Russell Wilson as his quarterback. For more on this story, here's Don.
Now joined by NFL insider Jay Glazer, the best in the biz. You broke this story. Why did this deal go down?
Look, Seattle Seahawks, I think, are a different place than most. It's either going to be on board with the attitude they have over there, or you're not. And if you're not, they don't care who you are, you're gone. And that's really the gist of what happened here with Percy Harvin. There was a lot of issues behind the scenes with Percy. It's been going on for a while. And they have a different attitude than most. They'll swing away, I think, more than most guys like John Schneider, the GM over there, and Pete Carroll. They'll take, you know, different chances. But if it doesn't work out and they see it's going to be an issue with the team, they're like, hey, we're going to move on from you. We are about a team attitude, and up there it's a little different. You know, and you're Seattle, you're kind of away from everybody else, and I've been up there a bunch, and it really is a different atmosphere than most teams. So there has been a lot of difficulties there with Percy, And they pretty much just had it. It was time for them to move on. And, you know, they only took just one draft pick. So it's not like they said, hey, let's do a whole fire sale. There were issues there. They wanted to stop it right now and move on.
The Jets are 1-6. There's a lot of teams out there who would love to have a 26-year-old playmaker. Why did he go to New York?
You know what? John Idzik, the general manager there, he worked in Seattle. If John Idzik was not the GM of the Jets, they wouldn't have had Percy Harvin. But John Schneider and John Idzik have a very good relationship. Schneider told Idzik all the issues that they have had with Percy. And I think Idzik right now, look, we saw the other night, right, is all the criticisms he's getting out there that he has not given Rex Ryan enough weapons. He hasn't given them enough personnel, hasn't used enough cap. Well, you go out and you get perhaps the best offensive weapon in the National Football League.
Wow.
That certainly will answer some of those questions. And here's the bottom line, too. Because they didn't have to give up a lot, if it doesn't work out, they move on. They really didn't give up an awful lot. But the bottom line here, again, is Seattle looked at this with Percy because of these problems that he was having there, and they just said, hey, it's time for us to just cut cord and move on.
Wow, the Jets haven't had a Pro Bowl receiver since Keyshawn Johnson in 1999. Jay Glazer breaking it down for us here on Fox Sports Live.
Still lots more to come on Fox Sports Live. It's the biggest game of the weekend. We're on the ground in both Tallahassee and South Bend to preview the top five showdown between Notre Dame and Florida State.
Plus, sweat, tears, and a lot of champagne. We'll relive the Giants and Royals' incredible run to the World Series from the fans' perspective.
Plus, you think James Shields is worried about facing the Giants in game one?
I did pretty well against them earlier this year.
Big again, the Royals ace joins our World Series champ Gabe Kapler next.
I don't know if you can hear me. There's something stalking us. And now it's hunting me.
Alien Isolation, out now. Rated mature.
And I'll find my way, cause it's love, real simple, and that's how it works. Oh, so won't you just give it up, cause you don't understand. Big it up, but you don't.
Join the Mile High Club.
Yes.
Now anyone can join the Mile High Club. Introducing the Mile High Bacon Thick Burger at Hardee's and Carl's Jr.
When a pro at any 2014 PGA Tour event sinks a hole-in-one, Quicken Loans will pay your mortgage for an entire year.
That is how it's done. Truly amazing.
Get in the hole-in-one sweepstakes. Enter today at pgatour.com/quickenloans, and you could have your mortgage paid for an entire year.
Steel. German engineering. American manufacturing. Servicing dealers. And people across America who refuse to compromise. Right now, legendary steel chainsaws start at just $179.95. Hardworking steel blowers start at just $149.95. Real people. Steel people. Join us. Visit steeldealers.com.
Get a large two-topping pizza for just $7.99 at PizzaHut.com. A deal this good only lives online. So for a limited time, try the $7.99 online deal any day of the week when you order at PizzaHut.com. The best Pizza Hut deals live online. Pizza Hut.
Discover Axe Daily Fragrances, created by the best perfume designers in the world to complement your style. Experience Axe Redesigned.
Hi, Pete Rose here, in the hall. I love being in the hall. It's the perfect place to walk down memory lane in my Skechers Relax Fit shoes. They've got cushioned Skechers memory foam and a roomy toe area. So whether you're in the hall or anywhere else, wear Skechers Relax Fit shoes.
Pete, you're not supposed to be in the hall.
I can't catch a break.
Try relaxed fit shoes and sneakers from Skechers. Comfort included.
Two dudes in suits talking college football. Boise State hosting Mountain West rival Fresno State. First quarter we go. Boise State up 10-3 on that blue turf. Martez Waller scoots to the outside. It's a race to the end zone. Guess who wins? 76 yards to the house. Fresno State ties it up at 10. Fast forward to the third quarter. Now Bulldogs down 27-20 after a Boise State fumbled kickoff return. Waller, 3 yards out. He had 164 yards on the ground, 2 touchdowns, game tied at 27. Fourth quarter we go, same score. Broncos with some trickeration. Although, it ain't tricking if you got it. Thomas Spurbeck, the reverse, the toss, finds the quarterback. Brent Hedrick, wide open, 9-yard score. So nice, we have to show you twice. Could that be the one?
That's what's
Boise
up.
State, that's what's up. Boise State goes on to win 37-27. They take that milk can.
Temple in Houston, Greg Ward Jr. getting his second career start at quarterback. Let's flash back, shall we? 2 weeks ago, Houston on the doorstep of upsetting UCF down 5, just over 30. 30-